Good morning, Knights, and welcome back to the Westmount Highlights. It's the week of February 15th, 2021. Before we continue with our hashtag Beyond February interview of the week, let's take a look at what's coming up. There's no school for students this week on Monday or Friday. That means that Tuesday, February 16th is a day 7 in your timetables. Course selections were made available last Friday and are due this Thursday at 6 p.m. After that, the Google form will be turned off, so please make sure you get your selections in as soon as possible. Big thank you to Ms. Karen and Ms. Mandy for hosting the evening information sessions on Zoom for all parents and students. Last week on Thursday and Friday, you all got festive, dressing up in your best pink, red, white, and purple. Thank you to the Student Council for organizing the event, and also for these lovely t-shirts that were distributed to staff members on Friday. Thank you guys, really awesome job on that. This week, Malachi has a review of the week. Brandon's putting the Riddler hat back on. Gowrish and Bennett are taking care of history duties. But first, Safa and Serna sit down with Ms. Mack for this week's installment of Hashtag Beyond February.
Hi, and welcome to the Westmount Highlights. I'm Serna.
And I'm Safa.
Hi, my name is Ms. Mack, and I'm the art specialist here at Westmount High School.
Why did you decide to become an art teacher?
So I decided to become an art teacher because it just came very natural to me. I've been painting for a very long time and creating art, and it's something that I do as a hobby on my pastime. I love working with students as well.
What made you think of the idea to decorate the doors for the classrooms?
I really thought that it would be a good idea to decorate the doors because it would be really interesting and nice to have a whole hallway paying tribute to Black leaders, Black history.
What is the message you want to spread as a Black artist?
I want to raise awareness of highlighting the beauty of our community and also raising awareness for social justice and social change.
Who is your favorite Black artist and why?
So my favorite Black artist, his name is Ella Natsui, and he is a Nigerian artist, and he creates monumental installation art pieces. And what's very beautiful about his work is that he takes recycled found objects and makes it into something new.
Is there any people that inspire you and make you do better?
My mother inspired me quite a bit. She was also an artist and a photographer. And I get my inspiration, believe it or not, from politicians, you know, like Michelle Obama and Kamala Harris, and also two important iconic figures like Oprah Winfrey. That's who inspires me.
What do you think about Black History Month?
Black History Month is very important. I think it's important that we pay tribute to ancestors and take this month to explore Black history, the meaning of it, you know, not just to emphasize on slavery, but to also talk about other important elements.
What is your favorite art form?
My favorite art form is painting with oil paint or watercolor. And it's just my favorite type of medium to work with because I feel really free when I'm working in this medium and it's fun.
What is the biggest lesson you've learned over the years as a Black artist?
The biggest lessons that I learned was when I exhibited at the Museum of Fine Arts. The exhibition was called The Power of One, and we were a collective group of Black artists here, the first group of Black artists from Quebec to actually exhibit at the Museum of Fine Arts. And I knew that we can break boundaries. So art has the power to change and make a difference.
Well, thank you very much for letting us interview.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Hello, Westmount High. I'm Elliot, and welcome to Elliot Has a Question. This week's theme, Marvel. But first, let's look at the answers for last week's questions. Remember, get all three answers right, and you get a shout-out in next week's episode.
Now, no one got all three answers to last week's questions right, but I figured, why not put one person up here for getting two questions right?
Let's begin with the questions. Question number one, what was the name of the dog in WandaVision? Question number two, what was the first movie in the Marvel Cinematic Universe? Question number three, what year was comic book writer Stan Lee born? This has been Elliot, and thank you for watching. Have a good day.
Oh, Canada, our home and native. hatred, love in all of us coming.
Hey, Garwish, why are you singing O Canada? It's not July 1st yet.
I know it isn't, but today is when Canada officially adopted the Maple Leaf flag.
Oh, I thought it was always like that.
Nah. The red ensign was our flag, but since it looked like the Union Jack and Canadian troops were being misidentified as British troops, we decided to change it.
Oh, you and I had no idea. So, happy Maple Leaf Day then?
Happy Maple Leaf Day.
Happy Maple Leaf Day.
Welcome back to the Westmount Highlights, and today I'm going to be telling you this week's riddle. If you have me, you want to share me. If you share me, you don't have me. What am I? Post your answers in the comment section for a chance at a shout out in our next episode.
Hey guys, it's Malachi again. And today, I'll be reviewing the Disney Plus original series, WandaVision. If you're somehow unfamiliar with these two characters, Wanda and Vision, well, there's these two superheroes from the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and this is a show solely about them. The first two episodes dropped on Disney Plus on January 15th of 2021, and they were awesome. So, the story follows, Wanda Maximoff, aka Scarlet Witch, and the Vision, as they're trying to fit in their new lives after the disaster of Avengers Infinity War and Endgame. And they're trying to lead a normal life, ignoring the fact that Vision's a robot, and she has magical powers. Obviously, things go wrong, but I'm not going to spoil the entire show for you because that's what this review is for you to go watch it. So yeah, I hope you enjoy the show. Please like, subscribe, all that YouTube stuff, and I'll see you on next week's video.
Alright, you know what that sound means. It's time for birthday shoutouts. So let's take a look at who's celebrating the big day this week. Sophie Ray, Isaiah Williams, Cordell Diaz, Wu Jin Yan Yang, Dustin Banty, Moomin Hafiana, Tess McKenna, Kayla Ambrose, Marwa Bibi, Sayeda Bukhari, Azur Coombs, Leanna Gibbons, Mikayla Nelson, James, Ryan Cuthbert, Elizabeth Zhen Ho, Yunhao Liang, and Kiara Bloomer Sukdeo. Happy birthday to all of you. I hope you guys have a great day. We'll be back next week with another episode. Until then, we'll keep the nightlights on. Be well.